Good morning, everyone. We are here with you through the mid-morning hours to get you ready for all the big events in your neighborhood.
The Weather Channel has you covered from coast to coast. And Greg, it was all about the tornado yesterday in Florida.
Yeah, the tornado that we were tracking yesterday through North Florida now rated an
and clearly it did.
Was that one that moved onshore as a water spout or did it actually come across land?
All originated, though, over the Gulf of Mexico, but it moved all the way, the way across.
Wow. Indeed. Scary time.
Yeah.
Well, we can show you now how that skyline looked yesterday. I mean, very ominous. You saw the darkening. Look, it was very obvious on radar, as well as some of the sky views that we were watching here. And, you know, thankfully everyone seemed to take cover and, you know,
I think there was one injury report,
there was an injury here, but thankfully no fatalities.
Right. This kind of shot is characteristic of tornadoes in the deep south, in particular in Florida, with so much moisture around. They're sometimes real hard to see. Mm-hmm. I think that was also the case yesterday, although we did get a glimpse of it. Mm-hmm. You can see that on the horizon. But you know what? Storm and flood threats pepper today.
Delay program going into effect for you today due to the weather that Jen just talked about. But unfortunately, a lot of problems are really here into the Northeast where we've got the rain, the wind causing some issues for us, not just delays, but we're talking ground stops at a few airports, actually. So we're going to kind of take a look, closer look at the conditions here for LaGuardia, Newark, even down towards Philadelphia with the thunderstorms around, low ceilings for some of you causing the issues as well. And for some of you, it's also a crosswind like the Long Island Expressway, the Southern State Parkway, Northern State. This is where you have a wind coming in off the water, and those gusts along the east end of I-95 are going to be at least 40 miles per hour, making for a rather bumpy flight, that is for sure, for those flights that do get off the ground, because as I mentioned, we do have ground stops for Philly, Newark, and LaGuardia. There's your wind, your turbulence showing up as well across northern New England. Even that lighter blue, it's a bit of a bumpy flight, so, you know, if you're not kind of used to that sort of thing, make sure you have the medicine down into West Virginia. It's going to be later on this evening where we see some of those higher turbulence reports coming on through. So for today, the I-70 corridor being impacted, as well as Detroit, where, of course, your Tigers got rained out yesterday. They're going to play ball again tonight. And there's your wet weather along the West Coast, where I-5, and yes, even that severe weather potential over eastern, east of the Cascades in Oregon into Idaho and northern Nevada, Jen.
Has a job. He could be a roving tornado siren.
Yeah, my dog Penny would not be doing that. She might bark at the tornado siren. I don't know. We don't hear them too often.
I try to harmonize.
Yeah, harmonize, exactly. Very cute, though.
All right, well, Kelly, good day for you to be on the show.
I know. I just found out this morning when I walked in the door, you guys are discussing lakes in New York.
Yes, we are.
That's like my favorite.
With the weather for you here at the Masters. They had to end for darkness yesterday, so they'll finish up round one today.
So Masters weekend is really the one weekend of the year where I can really do absolutely nothing but watch the Masters. And I did that yesterday. I'm going to do it again today. The weather today, much better than yesterday.
Yeah. Still a little windy.
But the wind is going to make it real hard for the players.
I mean, wind was a factor yesterday.
Yeah.
It was difficult. I'll call it difficult conditions yesterday. So let's look at where the wind is coming from and how it's going to affect you here on the 13th hole. Mm-hmm. A strong west wind, 15, maybe 20 mile per hour plus, and cutting right across. So they tee off down there, Greg. The wind might actually help get them over the trees, though, right?
Yeah, it's real tricky, though, because there's such tall trees there. The wind at 100 feet is doing something much different than the wind at 20 feet. So when you're creating these shots, you got to account for it all. Very difficult.
It's going to make it really challenging today.
Yeah.
I'm no expert golfer, but I really don't know how you would play that with the wind and the trees and everything else in that on that particular
hole.
It's
the wind shear. We talk about that with severe weather. It's also a problem for us golfers.
Yes. Well, Saturday and Sunday look better, though. Wind will be calmer. Temperatures heat up by Sunday. 85 degrees.
Yeah.
It's going to be hot.
Make sure you hydrate with adult beverages, maybe. We'll see.
Maybe a little tea and lemonade.
For Jen.
Boston Marathon on Monday. It is Marathon Monday. This forecast looks great.
Who couldn't? This is the perfect marathon weather. Right around 60. A little bit of a breeze and, you know, partly cloudy skies.
And no rain in the forecast.
Right.
We had rain last year. Going back over the last several recent years, we've had rain a few times. But this looks like a pretty good one, both temperature and precip-wise.
Yeah, and while lots of folks may be looking
out there aren't a guarantee necessarily, but they're going to be around. And the kind of weather that's really difficult to kind of pinpoint when the shower is going to be there, you know, spinning underneath this upper level.
And it's on both sides of that low. Yeah. You've got different wind directions, though. So on this side of the low, it's a southerly wind bringing all that moisture in from the Atlantic, from Boston to Cape Cod. I mean, look at these gusts.
Yeah.
Nantucket, over 40 miles an hour. Hold on to that steering wheel there in Boston, 35 gusts, but a steady wind at 22.
And a decent plume of moisture coming in there. Mm-hmm. So we'll have to keep an eye on heavy rainfall. These showers will be a little bit lighter, but this comes on very saturated ground after yesterday's rain. So showers in Cleveland, showers heading back to Pittsburgh.
Buffalo, 33, gusting to 45. You need that umbrella, hopefully not going inside out.
I know.
With that rain coming down. And yes, there's a bit of blue showing up here, Jen. It's mainly going to be the hilly terrain up across the higher elevations, but primarily rain, 1 to 2 inches can be expected.
April rain, or April snow is the worst. We've got showers out there today, mainly the rain variety across Ohio and West Virginia. More coming back into Maryland, too. And Somerset, Maryland is one of the spots that have some kids on remote learning today because of flooding. I mean, so much weather over the past 36, 48 hours.
Pittsburgh got inundated. We had a flash flood emergency yesterday. More rain coming through later this morning, or late tonight, I should say. Through tonight into tomorrow, you've got the rain through the Mohawk Valley Capital District. And there's your snowflake activity showing up higher elevations. And then you think it clears out by Saturday night, but we've got another thing coming through on Sunday.
Wind advisory for today. So windy across lower Michigan. It's going to be windy across northern Indiana and Ohio. And, you know, it really is going to be windy everywhere, but just kind of reaching advisory levels in those spots.
Today happens to be National Big Wind Day.
Oh, is it?
Just
it?
Happens to be. I just looked it up.
Mount Washington, you can celebrate.
And there's your coastal flood concern as well. But, Greg, we need to look ahead to the next system because we could see a lot of.
You can see it on the water vapor. I mean, look at this big old dip that we've got out here. This is going to be the energy that moves into the west here. It swings on in, helps encourage rising air and rain and showers and maybe even some thunderstorms. Already see some showers out there, not quite in Portland yet, but maybe in the area. And down along coastal Oregon, a few showers out there. Everyone else sitting pretty good right now. But later today, there may be some thunderstorms. Watch into that. Idaho, more into Oregon tomorrow. And this is the kind of weather system when you get these upper level lows that move in. Sometimes they can create some small hail, maybe even an isolated tornado. It's possible. So just beware that we could have that kind of weather coming in. It'll be isolated, but not impossible. You see the showers forecast out here as you get through the day today and tomorrow right across Oregon. Again, very isolated in nature, but not non-existent. So we got to watch out for that. Some of the rain will be heaviest along the coast of Oregon down into California. That's kind of where the core of the system moves in. And we see rainfall moving into you tonight into the Bay Area. Showers down around San Jose. Rainfall tomorrow in Sacramento and through the Central Valley. Look at all this rain coming in overnight tonight and continue. So tomorrow morning, you're making your plans to go out to the farmer's market and do the other, Saturday morning errands. There's going to be rain out there. And by Sunday, it swings all the way down through Santa Barbara. Los Angeles getting some showers out there, scattered, and even San Diego, possible we get a few raindrops, but not as much as up to the north. Now, rainfall could be heavy at times with about 2 to 3 inches in spots, especially in some of those upslope areas. Snowfall, 6 to 12 inches, maybe above about 6,000 feet is where we're looking for that. But Yosemite could be impacted, so heads up if that is part of your weekend plans. San Francisco rain for you coming in late tonight and then tomorrow, Saturday night, but then ending by Sunday, and we're dry Sunday and Sunday night. Now, Kelly, out ahead of this, we might have some winds and fire. Truly unbelievable.
Just so amazing. I love that montage was in just under 4 minutes because totality for some places was right around that time, between 3 and 4 minutes.
Yeah, that was the max. Now, if that inspired you to witness the next solar eclipse in person, you've got some time to plan. You're going to need to grab your passport for the next several total eclipses. They'll all be overseas.
How about this location right here? Can you guess where that is?
Yeah, Iceland.
Iceland, yes. The next total solar eclipse set to happen on August 12th, 2026 over Greenland, portions of Iceland, Spain, Russia, part of Portugal as well. How cool would it be to see an eclipse over a volcano?
I mean, it's just a small part of Iceland, but it happens to be the part of Iceland that you're going to want to go to anyway.
And sometimes they get the northern lights, too.
Oh, gosh.
What about that?
Wouldn't that be amazing to have it all in one trip? Oh, the eclipse will be passing right over the beaches of Mallorca and Ibiza. You know, the beach is a nice spot to watch an eclipse. There aren't many things to maybe obstruct your view of the sky. And one thing I like about Mallorca is there's a lot of mountains. So you can kind of get up high. And if you get up high enough, you can actually watch the shadow move.
Just camp out or something.
Yeah, you can watch
And after that,
move.
Jen, the next eclipse has us headed down under to Australia, New Zealand. The total solar eclipse of 2028 will be the second of 5 eclipses in 15 years for Australia.
This would be another cool spot.
Yeah.
Parts of New Zealand, including here in Queenstown, will experience totality close to sunset. So you get the 360 sunset.
Right.
And then you'll get the sunset in the western sky.
And the opposite season of what we're in here in the northern hemisphere.
Yeah.
All that going on.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Finally, the total solar eclipse back here in North America in 2044. Now, on August 23rd that year, the path will only kind of touch us in the U.S. states, North and South Dakota and Montana.
But there will be another event in 2044. 45 that will be possible to witness from coast to coast across the U.S. A city like Orlando, how about right over Disney World?
Yes.
Being in totality right there, that's going to be amazing.
A lot of Florida will be in 2045, yeah. So I'm planning ahead to that one.